Good morning, everybody, to the Max Stern Athletic Center. We're live here at the second day of the 23rd annual Red Saracek basketball tournament featuring a Tier 2 qualifier game between the Weinbaum Yeshiva High School Storm out of Boca Raton and the Fuchs Mizrahi Mayhem out of Beechwood, Ohio. Yesterday, YHS gave an authoritative win over Block High School from St. Louis by a score of 64-38 with their two stars, Daniel and Ethan Lasko, both scoring in double digits. Coach Verdugo says his team is on the rise, and he's very confident about this tournament. Fuchs suffered a tough loss to a staunch defense from a first-year team, Nuju, out of California by a score of 55-44. We have the Hurricane facing off versus the Mayhem, and I'm not sure what you call that in the Weather Channel, but Josh, what do you think we're going to see here today?
Well, yesterday Fuchs showed us that their 14-2 record on the year was no joke. This team can play basketball. They're led by Ari Barshane and David Spiro. Their seniors, Yair Pulser and Evan Jaffe, they're the ones that Coach Hollins looks to step up. And of course, on the other side, Weinbaum led by Ari Clements and Daniel Lasko, coming off a great win. They're riding high. They're ready to come play basketball early this morning.
Sounds good. We have the starting lineups for today are Morty Bach for YHS with Ethan Lasko, Daniel Lasko, Ari Clements, and Jacob Danis. Looks like we're going to have a great game today. And back to the booth.
Starting for Fuchs, we have Evan Jaffe, Jeremy Sabach, David Spiro, Ari Barshane, and Yair Pulster. And this game featuring both teams feature a up-tempo on offense, defensive-minded game. Coach Hollins loved pressuring the ball up the court, really trying to force turnovers. And at the same time, I coach a spoke done, and Weinbaum's motto is defense creates offense. So you're seeing two of the same styles clash here in basketball, and it's going to be a great game today.
Tell me if I'm right, but the player to watch for in this game seems to be Ardur Barshane, who posted a double-double yesterday.
He had a double-double, but he's going up a great center today, and Jacob Danis. Can he have the game today that he had yesterday? That's going to be a key point for Fuchs Mizrahi.
As the tip goes, the ball rolls out of bounds after being tipped by Ardur Barshane, but it was touched last by YHS. Inbound to Evan Jaffe.
Sorry, a starter for Fuchs Mizrahi that I did not mention is Arye Sunshine getting the start for Fuchs Mizrahi today.
And there he is playing defense hard on the full court press. A good turnover forced by Yair Pulster, but fouled on the shot is Arye Sunshine.
And just 25 seconds into this game, we see the defense that Coach Hollins was talking about, pressuring up the court. They love to create those turnovers. They did one there, and Arye Sunshine went up big, and he's going to the free throw line for two with Fuchs Mizrahi already up two early
that
in this game.
Foul was committed by Morty Bach. That's his first of the game.
They called that foul on the floor, and Fuchs Mizrahi will take the ball out underneath their basket. Early in the morning, I'm sure both these teams are kind of cold. I saw Weinbaum got here very early, gotten a good warm-up. I think they got in a little better warm-up than Mizrahi did, but both teams are ready to play, and we see a great move there by Jacob Danis.
Ari Barshane. And the Storm turned the ball over on the inbound, and now it's coming back to Fuchs. Timeout, Weinbaum. You might think that the weather would affect the storm coming all the way from warm Boca Raton with our miserable winter that we have had this year in New York and Cleveland, and the Fuchs Mizrahi High School from Cleveland might seem a little bit more comfortable. That might explain why the storm came in really, really early this morning for a very long warm-up.
But at the same time, we can see Coach Verdugo not happy with the way Weinbaum's playing, and I'm sure Coach Hollins for Fuchs Mizrahi is just the opposite, very happy with the pressure his team is showing. Coach Verdugo needs to settle down his team, and they need to start getting past this great defense of Fuchs Mizrahi to try to set up their offense.
Coach Verdugo mentioned that he feels like his team is on the rise coming into Saracek, which makes him pretty confident. The Storm lost a lot of seniors to graduation last year, and they had to revamp their entire game plan for this one. They had a losing record for the first time in a while in the Florida High School Basketball Association. But towards the end of it, they started seeming like they were getting their chemistry together. This is Shevach with the ball, passes it back, going in for the drive, and fouled is number 5, Yair Pulser.
Great take by Yair. He saw the two defenders back up, had a straight line to the basket. He took it. They tried to step up just a little too late. They weren't able to get to the spot, and that's a blocking foul, and Yair Polster will go to the line for two. Foul was committed on Ari Clements, his first of the game.
By Ari Clements. Sounds good. There's a couple substitutions here for Weinbaum. Ari Clements is now sitting on the bench. And in the game are Evan Jaffe, Ethan Lasko. Taking the ball up the court is Evan Jaffe now, as he leaves it over to Ethan Lasko, passes it to his brother, Daniel.
And another quick turnover there by the Weinbaum Storm, attributed to the great defense of Fuchs Mizrahi. And something to notice is the great scoring balance of Weinbaum's team. Three players in double digits yesterday, as we mentioned before. And this whole season, they've had some great scoring differences by different players. Seven players leading the scoring.
Dish. Foul and one for Evan Jaffe. Fuchs is up 7-0 with the opportunity to complete a three-point play and make it 8-0. As we're about a minute and 15 seconds, 17 to be exact, into this game.
And with Weinbaum getting here so early, I thought they'd be ready to play. They definitely didn't seem to be cold coming into the game, but they're moving a little slow, letting Fuchs Mizrahi get to the basket a little too easily.
Add says Evan Jaffe hits the free throw. A must-do in high school tournaments like this. A strong full-court press that's broken by Weinbaum, and it's a one-on-one for Daniel Lasko, but they keep the ball as Adir Barshane deflects it out of bounds.
We'd also like to note that games today at TABC are being streamed by TABC TV. We'd like to thank them for doing everything that they're doing today for the games at TABC. You can also catch those games on maxlive.com.
Here's Lasko with a shot that gets tipped by, I believe it was Adir Barshane, hits the side of the backboard, and now Fuchs has the ball back as Evan Jaffe takes the ball up.
Ari Barshane with a nice move, catching the ball out on the high post.
Here's
and driving all the way to the basket.
Stern with the ball. Ooh. An errant pass from Daniel Lasko.
Seems like a rare
ball goes back to Fuchs.
Rare turnover there by Daniel Lasko. We know he likes having the ball. He likes controlling the floor. He's going to need to settle down. He might be a little nervous coming into this game. They're seated below Fuchs Mizrahi, who showed us they can play yesterday.
A beautiful inlet pass to Adir Barshane, who can't complete the layup. And now it goes back to the Storm.
5:38 left in the first quarter. Here's Fuchs Mizrahi leading 8-0.
I'm sorry, Josh. Here's Aria Schultz inbounding the ball to Ari Clements, who gives it back to Jacob Stern, who loses the ball, but a reach-in foul is called on Evan Jaffe of the Fuchs Mayhem.
Great defense there by Evan Jaffe. Just a little too much of a reach for the referee's liking, and he's called for the foul. But we're still seeing high court pressure by Fuchs Mizrahi trying to force turnovers.
A long three that's no good, attempted by Ethan Lasko. And here again is Evan Jaffe controlling the floor as he gives the in a beautiful, beautiful spin move by Adir Barshane, who lays it off the left side of the board and in. And a turnover by Ari Clements, a stolen by Yair Polster, but he gets called for the walk as he tries to recover the ball.
Yeah, great defense there by Yair Polster. Just unfortunately was moving a little too fast, got the ball, and just started walking.
Can't avoid those calls. Jacob Stern gives it to Ethan Lasko. And here he is back again with the ball. Ethan Lasko.
Weinbaum needs to start looking inside. to Ari Clements. He's trying to look for the ball. He's been open a few times, but it's you have to say it's a great defense by Fuchs Mizrahi in this 3-2 defense, trying to clog up the paint and make them shoot the ball, which we saw early in this game they couldn't do.
Another turnover forced, but Aria Sunshine missed the fast break pass. And it seems like the Storm have the ball back. I think the ref called a reach and foul again, but I'm not sure.
I think that was out of bounds off Ari Bershane's try to steal there, but the ball went out of bounds.
A long cross-court pass, and the three goes up. It's good for Daniel Lasko with the assist coming from his brother.
That's a big shot for R.A. Lasko coming just about 4 minutes into this first quarter. Hopefully that will settle him down. That's their first points of the game. They're going to be looking to him to take over.
Here's Shevach for three, rims in and out. Rebound goes to Jared Stern, who gives it to Daniel Lasko on the other side. Gets fouled on the pass, and it's on the ground.
And we see it immediately, just like I was talking about. Once he hits that first shot, he's going to want the ball back. He's going to want to take it to the hole. He's going to want to get some fouls and get to the foul line to get some easy points.
Seems good. If you notice, Fuchs is giving a pressure defense up at the top of the court and leaving the key a little bit open. And YHS is starting to take advantage of that by swinging the ball quickly. And now Fuchs has backed off that defensive style.
Great defense there again to clog the middle by Fuchs Mizrahi, and they'll get the ball back off the turnover. We know Weinbaum doesn't open games well sometimes too well. Last year as well, they had Eula came out and had a great first quarter against them, and they were able to come back. So we'll see if they can try to come back and get back into this game, but we see a nice move there by R.A. Sunshine to get into the paint.
Yeah, R.A. Sunshine just quickly cut across from right to left and had a beautiful left-handed lay-in there. And here's the pass to Daniel Lasko. Oh, and Aria Schultz gets a rough block there as he goes in for the layup. And Shevach gives it now to Yair Polster. Inlet pass to Adir Barshane, stolen by Ari Clements, but comes back to Fuchs as Shevach takes the free throw. From the free throw line, not exactly a free throw. And here comes Ethan Lasko. Turns the ball over, but a reach and foul is called. And it seems Fuchs is a little bit unhappy about that, but we've seen the refs have been calling those reach-ins, so you've got to be careful.
That's Jair Polster's second foul on the same type of play, trying to get that steal, just a little too aggressive for the referee. He'll have to sit with 2 minutes and 30 seconds left with two fouls in this first quarter. We still see Fuchs Mizrahi in that great 3-2 defense, very quick off the ball. Weinbaum's trying to swing the ball, but Fuchs Mizrahi is right out there off the pass.
Three ball gets launched by YHS, and Adir Barch takes down the rebound.
With 2 minutes left in the first quarter, I'd like to thank our sponsor, Sammy's Bagels, for a great breakfast this morning. Thank you very much, as we see a made basket there by Fuchs Mizrahi.
Foul called, and number two, Morty Bach, will shoot two free throws. I can mention now that I'm drinking Sammy's coffee right now, and it's delicious.
I had a bagel this morning, and it was also very delicious. As we see Morty Bach get to the line, that's pretty much the first time Weinbaum's been able to get the ball inside the paint for a good look inside. And to their credit, they were able to get the foul. Morty Bach went up strong, missed the shot, but was able to get to the line where he misses the first free throw.
Tough break there for Morty Bach. Those free throws that the rim just won't let into the hoop always frustrate players.
And we know Weinbaum's a great shooting team. They shot 60% from the field yesterday in their win. They're definitely going to have to do that today against this great defense of Fuchs to try to get back into this game and win it.
Morty finds his rhythm as he hits the second free throw. I have to say, both teams have a pretty impressive crowd showing up for early games like this. Great team spirit for both teams.
Ari Barshane all the way out at the three-point line, catching the ball, looking for a pass.
Ari Barshane can't control a rough pass on the end as he's triple covered in that situation, and the Storm coming storming down the court.
And that's
Morty Bach, and the three from Jacob Stern is no good.
But that's the type of basketball Weinbaum wants to play. Coming 7 minutes into the first quarter, that was the first time they had a rebound and try to push up the floor. That's exactly what Coach Dunn was talking about with his team. They like to get a rebound and push the ball.
The Storm's defense pays off in that situation, as Adir Barshane did have a nice inlet pass coming in from Evan Jaffe, but the pressure caused him to travel a little bit, and the ref saw it, and now it's the Storm's ball. Here's Daniel Asko with the ball, being guarded by Evan Jaffe. Jacob Stern moves it to the left. Back to Lasko, shoots a three, and that one is no good.
Quick shot by Lasko there. I don't think his feet were squared to the basket. Just a little too quick. If he would have squared his feet to the basket, he might have had a better shot at making that shot.
Josh, tell me if I'm wrong, but it seems like the Storm are having a rough time getting the ball past the three-point arc, and they're sort of shooting longer jumpers. I think they have to try to penetrate the paint.
Well, we see that with Fuchs Mizrahi's 3-2 defense, and that's a tribute to them. They're making them make those shots.
At the end of the first quarter, the score is 14-4, and we're going to go to commercial break. Stay tuned for the second quarter. Looks like it should line up.
I am an NCAA athlete.
I am an NCAA athlete.
I am an NCAA athlete.
I am an NCAA athlete. I train hard.
I train hard.
I train harder.
I study.
I study.
I study. I study hard. I study harder. I'm here to challenge.
To challenge assumptions.
To challenge my teammates.
I'm here to challenge myself. I am a Maccabee.
A Maccabee.
A Maccabee.
I am a Maccabee.
Welcome back to the Max Stern Athletic Center for this opening game on our Friday morning, second day of the tournament, between the Weinbaum Storm and the Fuchs Mizrahi Mayhem. The score right now is 14-4 to Fuchs, and the Weinbaum Storm have had trouble getting this game started, but this is something they are familiar with in Saracek. And it could be a product of the weather, as it's pretty cold outside and they're coming from warm Boca Raton. We'll see what they can do in the second quarter.
I think Coach Berdugo told his team to settle down, take good shots. The Fuchs Mizrahi Mayhem are playing great defense. They have to look for better shots. They have to swing the ball a little bit quicker, because Fuchs Mizrahi is just so quick to get out on the ball on a slow pass.
Here's Daniel Asko with the ball. A nice layup that he can't get to go, and the rebound goes to Fuchs' Joey Senders. And here's Evan Jaffe with the ball, who passes to number 31, Jordan Kreindel. Audrey Barshane back to Kreindel, lets it go and can't get it. Here's Jacob Stern storming down the court on the fast break. Lets it go back to Ethan Lasko, who now it's back in Jacob Stern's hands.
Great 1-2 punch by the two big men for Fuchs Mizrahi. Unfortunately, Jordan Kreindel was not able to make the shot.
Wyjess was able to settle that down. Lasko can't hit the layup, but rebound on a good hustle from the Storm's Morty Bach, and they keep the ball.
Great hustle play there. We love seeing that early in the morning. That's what Saracek is all about.
Here's a good shot that doesn't go for R.E.A. Schultz. Needs to find his rhythm. Evan Jaffe with the ball, dribbling well, but being defended well as well. Lets it over a three that, oh! Let the rim refused, and Storm get a good break there, as that could have been a tough three to take. Blocking foul called on Audrey Barshane, as number two, Morty Bach, avoided the charge by sidestepping to the left and getting the layup. Opportunity for a three-point play.
Great take there by Morty Bach. Unfortunately, REA Sunshine was not able to get in position there, and he was called for the – excuse me, not REA Sunshine. Ari Barshane, I believe, was not able to get there in time. We'd like to thank everyone for sending in their comments to the ClipKeepers inbox. We now know that Daniel Lasko and Ethan Lasko are cousins, not brothers. Thank you very much. If you have anything to say, please share it with us at the ClipKeepers inbox. Anything. Thank you very much.
Thank you for that information. And as Morty Bach missed his free throw, and the score is 14-4. Here's Audrey Barshane double covered. Oh, a beautiful pass to number 34, Zach Zlatan. And Fuchs keeps the ball as he couldn't hit the layup. Here's a launch from the three-point range that hits the side of the backboard, but rebound goes back, and he can't hit the layup. Rebound Fuchs again, a scuffle for the ball down low, and that is a jump going in favor of
Mizrahi. Mizrahi will keep the ball there. As we see something that Weinbaum's definitely going to need to settle or try to do a little bit better, and Fuchs Mizrahi is going to have to try to capitalize on when Ari Barshane gets the ball into the post. Weinbaum is quick to double team him, leaving a guy open, and we saw it there. Unfortunately, they weren't able to capitalize, but look for Ari Barshane to call for the ball, try to either spin to the basket or find that open man off the double team.
Here's the top of the arc, number 34, Zach Zlatan, who gives it back to their point guard, Evan Jaffe. Another inlet pass, contact taken by Audrey Barshane, who again can't hit a layup, but he gets his rebound, hustles again after the ball slipped out of his hands, and the ball is being kept by the Mayhem.
Great play there by Audrey Barshane, missed the first layup, got his rebound, went back up strong. He's trying to get the ball. He's going after every miss. He's trying to get the ball back for Mizrahi down on the low post.
Ari Barshane is really hustling down there, and eventually he's going to get it to go his way.
And I thought this game would come down to two things, turnovers and the battle of the big men, and right now Ari Barshane is dominating the inside the paint.
Oh, as the Storm tried to take the pass away from Ari Barshane, they got called for a little bit of a reach-in foul there, and Fuchs is going to keep the ball again. Ari Barshane's presence is being felt in the paint.
Folks, we'd like to remind everybody to keep it here for the Step It Up Basketball Halftime Show coming up in 5:14. You do not want to miss it. In-depth analysis of this first half where Fuchs Mizrahi is leading 14-4.
The Storm can't handle the rebound, and Fuchs keeps the ball again. This has been a long possession that they have not been able to capitalize on yet, but here they get another chance. The Storm force a turnover, and now Jacob Stern gets the ball.
Something we talked about before, Weinbaum's not able to push the ball. Mizrahi's making them set up in the half court where they are playing dominant 3-2 defense and not giving up anything in the paint.
As the Storm let the ball go out of bounds, it hit a Fuchs player's hand, and they're going to keep the ball. I have to say the Storm got a great break on that previous possession by Fuchs, as it was a long one and they avoided going down by even more. And the three is missed by Ethan Lasko, and here Fuchs gets the ball back.
I'd like to point out that there was no, Weinbaum did not try to get that offensive rebound. Once the shot went up, everyone kind of looked like they ran back on defense.
There's a long pass that cannot be controlled by Ethan Lasko, and it goes past the Fuchses on the previous play. Evan Jaffe did have a very nice baseline drive Now the score is 16-4 for the Mayhem.
Weinbaum's definitely gonna have to try to get some offensive glass, a position that Mizrahi is definitely dominating on. They have to start boxing out. They have to start going after missed shots to try to get back, try to cut
Storm,
this lead down.
Get the turnover here, and here comes Ethan Lasko coming down the court, throws up a layup, can't go, wanted the foul. The ref is not giving it to him, and here comes Evan Jaffe coming down the court.
With that, I'd like to thank our sponsors. As I said, Sammy's Bagels for giving us a great breakfast. Carlos and Gabby's for a great dinner last night. Ricky's Cookies, which are unbelievably delicious. If you want to order online, she ships across the country. Please use the promo code SARACHECK2014 for a 10% discount. ClipKeepa's inbox, as I said. The Columbus Tour Academy Baseball Invitational, which I had the privilege of playing my senior year. It is great fun for any of you, any of the teams with baseball teams. Please contact Columbus Tour Academy if you would like to join in that great weekend.
Both free throws are missed and the Storm get the rebound. Here's Ethan Lasko coming up the court fast. There you go. A nice rumble down the court by Ethan Lasko as he gets the short floater from the front of the hoop to go in.
And so that's Weinbaum basketball. When we see when they're playing their game, they can score. They want to get the ball up and push. They're able to score a nice two there and cut the lead down to 10 with 3:17 left in the first half.
Defense by the Storm forces too many steps by the Fuchs Mayhem, and they get the ball back. Wyges has been able to keep the Mayhem under control this quarter, and if they can get their points scoring going strong, they might be able to really get back into this game. A foul in favor of the Storm, and the ball will be inbounded.
Something we're seeing Weinbaum do is trying to get into the paint, trying to get the ball, not settling for a shot, but trying to get the ball inside the paint. We'd like to remind everybody that the games at TABC are being streamed live right now. Right now, Ida Crown is in a game against Berman. Please check that out on Max Live, and we'd like to thank TABC TV for bringing that stream to you.
Make sure to stay tuned. I'll get back to that soon as the Storm coming down the court. A beautiful pass. And Ethan Lasko is able to get the lay-in. Score is 16-8. Timeout, and Coach Verdugo is pumped. Make sure to stay tuned in 2 minutes and 36 seconds for the Step It Up Basketball Halftime Show. We're going to go to a commercial and be back for the end of the second quarter.
In America's heartland, where our national pastime thrives, you'll find one of the most unique baseball tournaments in the world. The Columbus Baseball Invitational. This spring, join Jewish high school baseball teams from around the country as they converge upon the fields of Columbus to do battle on the diamond and forge lasting friendships off the field. The Columbus Baseball Invitational. 3 days of Jewish unity, spirit, and oh yeah, did we mention baseball? The Columbus Baseball Invitational, where age-old tradition collides headfirst into America's favorite pastime. The Columbus Baseball Invitational. To secure your place, contact Columbus Torah Academy or go to www.columbusinvitational.com. See your team there this spring.
And we're back as Fuchs cannot hit the layup in the paint and the Storm get the rebound. Here is Daniel Lasko, who gives it over to Morty Bach, who can't hit the layup, but he gets a jump ball is called, and I believe that is going to the Storm, and it is.
And he said, as you said, going into that timeout, that Coach Verdugo was pumped because Weinbaum is finally playing their game. Those last two possessions, they were able to get out on transition offense, get some easy shots. That's exactly what Weinbaum wants to do, and Coach Hollins had to talk it over with Mizrahi Mayhem.
Here's Stern with the ball, gives it to Ethan Lasko. Cross-court pass is taken by Fuchs, who lets it go to David Spiro for the Mayhem, who crosses it over as Coach Verdugo is screaming for his player to cover the defense, and the three will not go. He might have been scared there by Coach Verdugo's intensity. Here's a nice bounce pass to the side. A foul called on the Mayhem. And it seems, if you notice, Josh, that the Storm have been able to get closer to the basket lately, and it seems to be helping them as they're about to shoot free throws.
Well, they haven't been settling for outside shots like they did in the first quarter and early in the second quarter. They're trying to get to the basket, trying to break the 3-2 defense of Mizrahi. They know the middle is going to be open, so they're trying to get to that point where they can go up strong and get to the foul, just like they did there.
Here's the first free throw. Good. Coming from Boca, I'm sure the Storm are aware of Mike Biamonte, the Heat's announcer, who has three rules of life. They are make your free throws, and make your free throws. Both of which Ethan Lasko was able to do right there.
And we saw it yesterday in the MTA game against Ida Crown, that thrilling game that came down to two free throws. Little things like that are going to win the game, and when you have ice in your vein coming down in the game, you can carry your team.
The Storm are excited right now as they just forced a turnover and they get the ball back, only down by six with a minute and a half left in the half. And here's Lasso cutting across the court with that beautiful layup that just won't go. And Ari Barshane with the rebound. The ref will not give the Storm that call, and he seems to have a rough time there as the Mayhem get the ball back and we're back to a lead by eight.
Great outlet pass there by Fuchs.
Being double covered, and the Storm control the ball, give it to the three-point by the Lasko, and he gets it. Weinbaum has cut the lead to five as we just have begun the minute countdown.
Noah Lasko getting back up after that hit, able to drain the three right in front of the Fuchs Mizrahi bench.
Here's Evan Jaffe with the ball. Aria Sunshine to Ari Barshane. Walk called by the ref, and the Storm get another turnover, and this lead has disappeared as the YHS has a chance to make it a one-score game on this possession.
There's a great pass there by Aria.
Tied up. A turnover forced by Evan Jaffe. He gives it to Spiro. And here are the Mayhem on the other side of the court as the 30-second countdown, who launches it over to Jaffe on the other side.
Smart basketball play there by Spiro to bring the ball out. Saw that he was underneath the basket, was able to control it, bring the ball out, and I think Mizrahi will have the final shot with 14 seconds left in the half.
Important possession here because this could define the momentum going in the second half. And the Storm force a turnover, and here they are storming down the court. A good pass from one Lasko to the other, and he can't control it going back to the Mayhem with 4 seconds left. I think the Storm just want to prevent a shot from being launched here as they can go into the half only down by five, as they went to this quarter down by 10.
That would have been a huge possession for Weinbaum. Unfortunately, the Lasko Cousins could not connect.
Shot cannot really be launched up, and we're about to send it down to the sideline to my friend Avi, who's going to speak to Dwight Hollins, of the coach of the Mayhem.
Coach, Your team has a 5-point lead going to the second half. What do you think you have to do to maintain your lead and really pull off the win tonight? Today,
first of all, we got to make shots. That's number one. We missed about four or five easy layups. And second of all, we got to get back and play better defense. We're making stops, but we can do a little bit better than what we're doing right now.
Who do you think is the X factor in the second half?
Evan Jaffe and Ari Barshane. We have to make sure that, first of all, we're controlling the ball offensively, getting us into our offensive sets, and then we got to do a better job in finishing in the post.
Perfect, Coach. Thank you so much. Good luck in the second half. Back to you guys in the booth.
Thank you, Avi. Thank you very much. So here we are for the Step Into Basketball halftime show. The score is 18-13 for the Mayhem, and we're about to go to commercial break, but make sure to stay tuned for the Step Into Basketball halftime show, and we'll recap the first half for you when we come back. It looks to be an exciting second half as YHS was able to cut that lead, and they seem to have momentum going into the second half. Here we go after the commercial break.
The early days, when I started Step It Up in 2009, I had a vision, but I wasn't sure exactly where it would take me. We started with one private training session, an hour on the court, myself and a player, one-on-one skill development, and when I left that session, I knew I was on the verge of something special.
This is our third year this year. So that first year, we had like 25 kids, we just gave them everything we got from them, that base, word started to spread, and we've, you know, grown since.
Although Step It Up has grown immensely in the last 3 years, that YoGive has really mastered the giving the kids the type of attention they need.
What he's developed over the last 3 years, and as far as the coaching skill, his development skills, and just the whole program in itself, it's just really...
All right.
America's heartland, where our national pastime thrives. You'll find one of the most unique baseball tournaments in the world. The Columbus Baseball Invitational. This spring, join Jewish high school baseball teams from around the country as they converge upon the fields of Columbus to do battle on the diamond and forge lasting friendships off the field. the Columbus Baseball Invitational. 3 days.
Hi, everybody. Welcome back to the tail end of the Step Into Basketball Halftime Show here at the Max Stern Athletic Center on the second day of live coverage of the Red Saracen Basketball Tournament. Here we have our game score 18 for Fuchs Mayhem to 13 for the Weinbaum Storm. I'm David Ellenbogen here with my partner, Josh. And we're going to recap the first half for you right now, as the first quarter was pretty much dominated by the Mayhem. And Weinbaum seemed to find their rhythm in the second quarter, giving pressure down low to the Mayhem as they were not able to hit some key shots in the key, and then being able to penetrate past that staunch defense that Fuchs gave them in the first quarter and cut the lead from 10-5. Coach Verdugo was fired up going into halftime, and we'll see how he can use that momentum to go through to the second half. Josh, tell me what you think Fuchs needs to do to maintain their lead and what the Storm should do to take it over.
Well, Ari Barshane has to continue being dominant. Already has 6 points and 8 rebounds, a few of them on the offensive side, being able to put up second shots. Those second chance points for Ari Barshane are going to hurt Weinbaum. And for Weinbaum on the opposite, they're going to have to continue playing their game as they did going into halftime. They finally started getting a rebound and pushing the ball up, which they did not do in the first quarter, which is why they had such a deficit going into the second quarter.
Thank you. The Storm have just entered the gym again from halftime, followed by their coach, Yoga Verdugo. And this half seems to be a good one, as we are about to start it in 20 seconds.
And as we heard Coach Holland say right before halftime to our sideline reporter, Avi J. Schwartz, they're going to have to knock down shots. They missed a few shots. They had second chance opportunities, but they weren't even able to put those in. For Mizrahi to continue leading into this game, they're going to have to make their first shots, or when they do get those offensive rebounds from Ari Barshane, put that ball back up.
That's a very important key to the game, as Fuchs was able to get a lot of offensive rebounds, but they were not able to capitalize on those short shots in the paint, as they're about to inbound for the second half, and it goes to Ari Barshane. Pass to Shevach, handles the ball and gives it to Yair Polster, who turns around and gives it to Evan Jaffe, who drives, goes for the reverse layup, and doesn't get it to roll. Here is Morty Bach dribbling down the court. Stolen by Ari Barshane. Evan Jaffe with the ball now. Beautiful pass inside to David Spiro, who gets a controlled layup to go in. And the Storm are having a rough time getting it down the court as Fuchs forces a turnover, and a foul is committed by Aryeh Schultz on Shevach, and he will shoot two.
Fuchs Mizrahi came out in this second half just like they came out in the beginning of the game, with up-pressure defense all the way up the court, forcing turnovers, getting good shots inside the paint, close to the basket, not giving Weinbaum anything on the offensive side of the ball.
We obviously haven't had much time to see what's going on, but it seems like Coach Hollins did speak well to his team in the locker room, as he did say the most important part of the second half is to either get fouled on those easy layups in the key or make them, and that's what they've been doing. Jeremy Shevach misses both free throws, and the score is 20-13. Here's Daniel Lasko with the ball. Layup doesn't go. Ari Barshane with the rebound. He is a rebounding machine, as yesterday he posted a double-double. And today, he's been getting a lot as well. Here's Spiro with the ball. Throws up a layup. Can't get it to go. Ari Barshane doesn't get the rebound. The ball is staying with the Mayhem on their side of the court.
Great play there by Lasko and Barshane to go for the basketball. Lasko seeing the big man coming towards him but not giving up on the ball, and unfortunately it will stay with Mizrahi.
Here's Spiro with the ball, inlet pass to Ari Barshane, who gets called for the walk there. He's got to dribble on those situations, because the Storm are sort of frantically trying to take him because they're scared. Hopefully he can get his rhythm going soon.
It seemed as Ari didn't know just how far away he was from the basket. Thought he was a little bit closer, tried to turn around and put the shot up, but he was just a little too far out and he had to walk.
Yeah. He is a force on the court, as he has been today, and the Storm are showing some fear But their defense against him has been working. It seems like Coach Verdugo has a solid game plan against him. Here's Ethan Lasko with the layup. YHS puts the lead back to 5 for the Storm as we have this slightly slow, controlled start to the second half here. Here's Evan Jaffe, defended well by Jared Stern, but he gets an inlet pass to David Spiro.
Great pass there by Evan Jaffe to David Spiro down low. Going across his body to get the ball down low.
A nice crossover by Lasko, who gives it to Bach, who gives it over to Schultz, gives it back to Daniel Lasko, who can't get the three to go. I have to say, David Spiro in the second half has been in the zone here. He's been cutting well, and he hasn't had so many minutes in the first half. It seems like the Storm might have to have him figured out here.
Once again, we see a lot of, like you said, a lot of off-ball movement for Mizrahi trying to penetrate this Weinbaum Storm defense as we see a cut there by Spiro.
He pulls it back, didn't like the lane he had, but, a nice drive fouled by Daniel Lasko. Is number 5 Yair Polster. He'll shoot 2. And I have to say, David Spiro is controlling the pace very well on their side of the court.
And I think as a team, they're having great ball movement. They're swinging it around the court. When they see an opening in Weinbaum's defense to get down low and to get to the paint, they're going to take it. But they're also going to swing the ball out, try to run down some clock with this 22-15 lead.
Yesterday, David Spiro did have a pretty solid game, scoring 10 points on 3-for-8 shooting, including 1 for 33% from three-point range and 100% from the line. He might seem to be a impressive presence here in the second half as he's playing staunch defense on the full court press.
As Yair Polster missed both those free throws for Mizrahi, they're getting into the lane, they're getting some good shots, they're getting fouled, they're going to have to start making some free throws.
Here's Spiro with the ball to Ari Barshane. Jaffe, Shavach. Fuchs moving the ball around very well. The Storm, on that possession at least, were able to keep it away from the hoop and have prevented the Mayhem from getting up a shot well. Here's Jaffe coming in. Turnover forced by the Storm as they were again able to prevent the Mayhem from penetrating the paint. Here's Stern coming up the court. I believe a timeout was called by the Storm before the shot was released. And seems like Coach Verdugo wants to speak to his team.
Coach Verdugo probably talking about how the ease of Mizrahi being able to swing the ball. They're going to have to step up maybe a little bit on defense, maybe leave the middle a little bit more open, but Mizrahi has been able to swing the ball way too easily, I'm sure, for Coach Verdugo's liking.
Again, the lead is still 7 points, so YHS has been able to keep the Mayhem under control this quarter. They're still trying to take over the lead. But I will say, although at the beginning of the half, the Mayhem did get some good layups and fouls, but now here with 4:25 left, almost halfway through, the Storm seem to have gained their composure as their defense has locked down on the Mayhem since that lead became 7. And here's the inbound. Daniel Lasko giving it to Stern on the inbound pass, who can't hit the layup. Shevach with the rebound.
As we see, just like maybe I was talking about before, a little up court defense on Mizrahi, so they're not able to swing the ball like they've been doing.
Yes, and there you go. They force an outside shot that didn't go in. The Storm got the rebound. They have been able to guard the paint this quarter very well. Here's Ethan Lasko. Can't hit the floater, Evan Jaffe coming down the court quickly, gives it over to Spiro, who hits the layup. He has been very, very composed this quarter, and the Storm have to try to figure out how to keep him under control.
And he is their spark off the bench. Didn't get the start today, but when he came in, Mizrahi has been playing very well. Him and Evan Jaffe have linked up many times off cuts. They seem to have a great connection together off the basketball.
Long pass by Jaffe, taken away by the Storm, and here's Lasko again, gets a blocking foul as the ref did not see the Mayhem's feet being planted as he came down the court on the attempted fast break.
Well, there Lasko was just able to sidestep Yair Polster there, who was set, but since he had that sidestep, Polster was out of position and the referee called a block.
I will say it seems like Ethan Lasko does have his charging fouls avoided correctly. He's done that about three times this game already. Okay, as Daniel Lasko misses the three-pointer, we'll give you an update on the game going on at TABC. Ida Crown is leading MTA, I believe, 25-5.
Berman.
He's leading Berman 25-5. At the game at TABC. You can see that on TABC TV if you're interested. A wonderful pass from Evan Jaffe to Ari Barshane, cutting across, and he gets the left side layup, to go in. And now the score is 26-15.
Evan Jaffe may not be scoring right now in the second half, but I believe every point that they've scored in this second half so far has been off an assist by Evan Jaffe, so he's getting into the game by those assists.
The Mayhem have been able to take their lead to 11 points right now, and the Storm are going to attempt to come back into this one.
The Storm, as we said, going into halftime, they were able to push the ball. Haven't really done that in the second half so far, with 2 minutes remaining in the third quarter, as we see a walk there by Ethan Lasko.
Too many steps by Ethan Lasko. Got called for the travel. Those have been frequent this game, and they've caused some costly turnovers for both teams.
Evan Jaffe, I think, wants to slow this game down a little bit with the lead at 11 for his team with a minute 45 left to go. Wants to get a good shot if they see the lane, as we see Ben Barshane get to the hole. And another offensive rebound, and that time he was able to put it in. That is going to be a dominant force for Fuchs.
Ari Barshane is... I'm sorry. Just to report, the missed three by the Storm. And here's Sunshine coming down the court. Ari Barshane has found his rhythm this quarter as he's been getting offensive rebounds and been able to hit the second chances. Evan Jaffe is called for the offensive foul as he misses the layup. The Storm get the ball back.
Great defense there by Daniel Lasko. Got his body in front of Evan Jaffe, and was able to set his feet. Evan Jaffe seemed to use his other elbow to kind of push off, and he was called for the charge.
Here's the inbound pass to Daniel Lasko from Morty Bach. Lasko with the ball back. And now it's taken by Aria Schultz, who gives it to Yitzi Kamenetsky. And the Storm, unfortunately, turned the ball over. They've been having a rough third quarter, a minute left. Fuchs has taken their lead to 13 points, outscoring the Storm by 8 this quarter. Here's Spiro holding the ball to Sunshine. Barshane, Spiro, who can't control the pass, but... the Mayhem maintain possession, and now Evan Jaffe, their point guard, with the ball.
With 35 seconds left, I'd like to remind, and a nice pass there by Jaffe.
Another wonderful pass by Jaffe, who has at least two assists this quarter. And Barshane hits his layup, something he might not have been able to do in the second quarter. And if he's able to hit those layups while getting offensive rebounds and nice passes from his point guard, Evan Jaffe, the Storm are going to have a lot to deal with.
I actually think Evan Jaffe has way more than that. Like I said before, I think every point for this quarter has come off an assist by Evan Jaffe. He is having a great third quarter, as we see high court pressure to end this third quarter by Fuchs Mizrahi.
I think Weinbaum should try to get up a nice, confident shot here, going perhaps an open three to cut the lead, because now they're down by 15. Three, two. Shot goes up, no good. We're going to go to commercial break at end here of the third quarter. Fuchs leads Winebound by 15 points. And by 15 points, that being 30-15, the Storm had a rough third quarter. We'll see you for the start of the fourth, see if the Storm can come back in this game. It's going to be my mission this tournament.
Welcome back to the start of the fourth quarter here, where Fuchs Mizrahi is leading Winebaum by 15, the score 30-15. Winebaum is going to need to start pressuring the ball and start playing their game, get some easy points off transition basketball, which they like to do to get back into this game in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, this fourth quarter should be an exciting one. I'm sure Coach Verdugo has had his team fired up for this one because he does not like to lose. And nobody should discount the Storm from this game, because yesterday, if any of you tuned in, MTA was leading by 17 in the third quarter and was down at the end of it as the Ida Crown Jewish Academy was able to just authoritatively stifle everything they tried to do, and hopefully the Storm were able to try to accomplish that. That game ended with MTA leading by one on two clutch free throws by Teichman.
And we know anything can happen at Saracek. Winebaum can certainly get back into this game with the style of game they play, as we see a shot there by Lasko misses off the front.
The jumper is no good. It's interesting to note that yesterday, in their win against
Block,
YHS shot a phenomenal 60%. But today it has not been so. The three by Sunshine is no good. Rebound to Daniel Lasko. I'm sorry. But the possession is maintained by the Mayhem.
We'd like to thank everybody watching out here and giving us feedback. Apparently a Gamarish here is watching their boys of Winebaum play, trying to get back, trying to cut this lead of 15. We'd like to thank everybody for listening. We'd like to, and if you have anything to say, please give us your feedback at feedback@maxlive.com, and it's the Clip Keepers inbox. And if you have anything to say, please let us know. As we see a travel there by Ari Barshane, he wants a foul hit in the hand, but the referee calls a travel. As Clements brings up the ball.
Here's Ari Clements with the ball. Gives it to Daniel Lasko. Goes up for the layup. Can't get it to go. Rebound Sunshine. Jaffe. And the jumper goes. The jumper goes for Joey Senders. The lead has climbed to 17 for the Mayhem.
Joey Senders getting into this game for the first time and making a splash with his first shot.
A nice dish from Ari Clements to Morty Bach. He can't get it to go. Ari Clements, as told me by his brother, is attempting to channel his inner Birdman for this game. Notice the hairstyle.
I think Mizrahi is going to look to slow the game up as we see a pass in there trying to speed the game up, but should try to slow it down.
Ethan Lasko, I'm sorry, and the pass cannot be controlled by Aria Schultz. The Storm turned it over again. And they keep coughing the ball up. By doing that, they won't be able to cut this lead down. And unfortunately, that great performance they had in the second quarter seemed to have weaned off here in the second half. I don't know what Coach Hollins told his team in the locker room, but it seems to have been working.
We had a few substitutions there for Weinbaum. Jared Stern comes into the game as a kicked ball is called on Weinbaum. And Fuchs will maintain possession.
Jump ball. That one, is, I believe, is going to go to the Storm, and yes, it will.
As we see Evan Jaffe trying to catch his breath, Yair Polster will check into the game. Evan Jaffe had a great third quarter, many assists. Didn't get on the score sheet, but he's getting in the score sheet off the assist to David Spiro off great cuts. He has great eyes for he has a great basketball mind, sees the game very well.
Here's Jared Stern, gives it over to Issa Kamenetsky. Here's Ethan Lasko with the ball, can't control his dribble, but picks it back up. Timeout, Storm. Coach Verdugo needs to speak to his team. We're about 2.5 minutes into the second half. And make sure to stay tuned for the next game after our post-game show. That will be between TABC and Yavne coming out of Dallas. TABC, that being out of them being out of Teaneck. That is a Tier 1 quarterfinal game, which should be exciting. Yavne, a highly ranked team this year. Their exact ranking will be coming up. I will get that for you in a second.
But and we'd like to remind everybody that the game going on right now at TABC is Ida Crown Berman. You can check that out also on Max Live. And we'd like to thank TABC TV for bringing that coverage to you today.
That matchup between Yavin and TABC is a 4-5 matchup, which should be an exciting one.
TABC played a great game last night. We're able to come out with the victory. They're going against a strong Yavne team who had a bye yesterday.
Both teams have large big men, with Yavne Academy sporting Adam Shore at a six, standing at 6'5", and Itai Gutman standing at 6'4", with Yoshua Zerman for the TABC Storm standing at a 6'4", and Zvi Rodblatt at 6'3", as the timeout ends. And the Storm are about to inbound the ball. Let's see if they can really take over in this last 5.5 minutes of this game.
Coming back into the fourth quarter, 5:32 left, Fuchs leading 32-15 as the referees have a chat before we get this game started again.
The refs pause the inbound for a second as they need to speak, and looks like Daniel Lasko is going to...
I believe something may be up with the clock. I'm not quite sure, but the referees seem to have it under control, and we will get this fourth quarter started again with 5:32 left.
Daniel Lasko took that opportunity to take a little breather on the sidelines. And here's Yitz Kamenetsky, who gets a beautiful left-handed lay-in to go on the left side. Nice finger roll.
We saw Mizrahi try to trap high pressure. That leaves the drive open when you have so many players outside. They're playing a 3-2, and a great drive there, easy to the basket for Weinbaum.
Fuchs turns the ball over. The Storm are going to get it back. That was a quick turnover for them. Storm can never get enough of those.
And I definitely don't think that's what Coach Hollins wants with this lead. I believe he wants his team to slow the ball down, try to take maybe up to one minute off the clock each possession. There's no shot clock here at Saracek. So look for
Mizrahi. Here's Jared Stern with the pass to Feintuck, who gets fouled on the layup. A little bit shaken up coming up.
But a great drive there.
Good sportsmanship from Max Sunshine there. Aria Sunshine, excuse me. As he seemed to encourage Feintuck as coming up from that rough shot.
And that's what Weinbaum definitely needs coming into this fourth quarter. They're going to need to score points with the clock stop, and that's going to happen at the free throw line, as I believe Fuchs Mizrahi called a 30-second timeout. As I said before, Fuchs Mizrahi is definitely going to have to slow the game down. They have a lead. They've been trying to do that pretty well, but they're still going to look for good shots. They're still going to look into the paint. to try to get a good shot, and Weinbaum's going to have to push the floor. With 5:06 left, Fuchs Mizrahi leading 32-17 as I believe Bryant is at the free throw line.
Brian Feintuck took it strong to the hoop before. And here he is shooting two free throws as he got fouled on that shot. He hits the first. He hits the second free throw. Again, free throws are probably the most important thing in any tournament, especially one that is with high school opponents. The Storm pressing the ball well, but be able to launch the cross. The layup cannot be scored, and the Storm are really playing good press defense here as they're able to maintain the ball, and they are down by 13 at this point, a three by Daniel Lasko as the loose ball foul gets called by Brian Feintuck, and the Mayhem will inbound the ball.
We see Weinbaum with the high court pressure, full court press, trying to get some steals, trying to play the game they usually like playing, which is an up-tempo style, trying to get some steals, and that will lead to quick points.
Coach Verdugo has instituted this strong press, although that time the Mizrahi was able to avoid it as they score a layup there. That point scored by number 34, Zach Zlatan, excuse me. And here the Storm with the ball back.
And with that high court pressure comes the challenge of getting back quick enough off the pass. The ball's going to move a lot faster than a body. Weinbaum's going to have to get back as we see a nice shot there by Lasko.
Nice shot there by Daniel Lasko, about a 19-foot jumper from the top of the arc. Here's Evan Jaffe coming down the court, but he's well defended and absolutely rejected by Ethan Lasko. That's the defense Coach Verdugo wants to see from his team. I heard that slap of the ball from here. Evan Jaffe forces the turnover, gives it over to Sunshine, who hits the layup. The lead is now 15 points again for Fuchs, scored by 34-21, 3 minutes and 35 seconds left here in the second half. Timeout Verdugo. The Storm will try to just, you know, score as many points as possible in this last 3 minutes. We're going to send it to commercial break in about 15 seconds. Everybody stay tuned for this last 3 minutes of this game. It should be an exciting one. And also make sure for the next game that will be between TABC and Yavne. Commercial break. Welcome back to the Max Stern Athletic Center for the final 3.5 minutes of this game between the Mizrahi Mayhem and the YHS Storm. We would like to give a mention to Evan Jacoby, as Jared Stern has the ball. Let me just report this play before we mention. Rabbi Shakis Kamarsh here is giving what they call a shout out to Evan Jacoby here in the game. I'm sure they're enjoying both Kamara and basketball there in warm and sunny Florida as the Storm are able to force a turnover. Excuse me in the confusion between the point guard and the shout-out. Here's Jared Stern with the ball. Three ball is good for Morty Bach.
Weinbaum with two quick shots there. the lead down to 9 with 2:54 left to go. Great move there.
Mizrahi is able to avoid the fast-paced charging defense of the Storm. Here is Stern coming down with the ball again. Here's Daniel Lasko. Coach Berdugo, three balls up, no good. Hits the back of the rim. Those are never pleasant. But I will say that the lead is right now at 9 for Fuchs. And 2 minutes. 11, excuse me, I'm sorry. The lead is at 11 for Fuchs.
And I know.
And that is not too much to score in 2.5 minutes.
And I know Weinbaum needs quick shots, but Daniel Lasko took a very quick shot there. Coach Berdugo not happy with that shot, having his hands raised after that shot. He knows he needs a three, but he wants a little better look than what Lasko just got there. As Ari Barshane checks back into the game for Mizrahi, has had a great game so far, looking to close it even stronger.
Foul is called against the Storm on the inbound pass there. They wanted a push off from the offense, but the ref was not having any of that.
As I said before, Ari Barshane has had a huge game. Ar had another double-double right now with 10 points and 11 rebounds, coming off a double-double loss yesterday. He is a great player, and he's going to look forward to the rest of this tournament.
Ari Clemens just checked into the game for Daniel Lasko. We'll see what Coach Verdugo's mindset is behind that. Inbound to Fuchs. Here's Evan Jaffe with the ball. Foul committed by Ari Clements there on Evan Jaffe. That's on the ground.
Mizrahi's still looking pretty fast-paced. As I'm surprised, I thought they'd be trying to slow it down a little bit.
Again, Rabbi Shockett's Gamarish here would like to give a shout-out to their boy Evan Jacoby.
Nice move there by Zach Slayton to get the bucket and the foul, go to the line to try to extend this lead with 2 minutes and 2 seconds left. And another shout-out for Weinbaum, this time coming from Rabbi Hoban, I believe it's pronounced. I hope I got that right, to his Talmidim, Jerry Stern, Ethan Lasko, and Mikey Pearl. Thank you very much. Once again, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns, please send them to the Clip Keepers inbox, feedback@maxlive.com.
Shots are now being thrown by Zach Slayton from the free throw line. The Mayhem fan base has now brought out pom-poms, something we may not have seen before at Saracek, but I can't say that for sure.
Weinbaum's going to have to move a little quicker than what they're doing right now. Lasko with the ball up top, try to look for a quick shot.
Three ball by Morty Bach, hits the back of the rim, no good. Foul called against Lasko as the Storm are intensifying their defense to try to get the ball back in an effort to come back, but things just don't seem to be working out for them.
And I believe that is 5 fouls on Daniel Lasko. I'm not sure if anybody sees that, but as Yair Polster gets to the line with Weinbaum trying to stop the clock, if they can make their free throws, they, even with this lead, they should win the game with a lead of 41-27 with a minute 42 left in the game, as they finally realize that Daniel Lasko has just committed his 5th foul and will be checking out for the rest of this game.
One more cross-country mention from Rabbi Landershear in Boca at YHS. Watching their boys here in Saracek from warm and sunny Florida.
Please keep it tuned for the post-game show coming up in a minute and 42 seconds, where we will be talking to Evan Jaffe, Ari Barshane, and Coach Dwight Hollins of Fuchs Mizrahi. As we see
Yair Polster miss the second free throw.
As we approach a minute and a half left in this game, 38-26 is the lead at the game taking place at TABC for Ida Crown over Berman. As Ethan Jaffe airballs a three there, and another foul is committed by the Storm. And being that there have been enough team fouls to warrant free throws, Fuchs will shoot two.
And that was another quick shot there by Weinbaum. Unfortunately, that's what they need at this moment. They just have to make them. They're taking a little quick, and that was a little short, and they have to commit the foul to try to stop the clock and hope for some missed free throws.
Of course, students and teachers at YHS are watching the game on maxlive.com from Boca as there Ethan Lasko hits a nice three. The score is 42-30 now. Foul again on the Storm as they try to keep the clock stopped. They're getting the best of both worlds watching through maxlive.com and hearing our report here as it's around 73 degrees in Boca right now. 45 it being here in New York. But here in the Maxner Athletic Center, the environment is always positive.
As we see Evan Jaffe at the line, who's had a great game so far, having so many assists in that huge third quarter for Fuchs Mizrahi, as they were only up a few points coming into the second half and able to extend that lead through Evan Jaffe's play in the third quarter.
Evan Jaffe hits his second free throw. We really can't stress the importance of his performance along with Ari Barshane's in the third quarter. If they were to stave off a comeback attempt, here's another three from Lasko that doesn't go, but the rebound for Aria Schultz goes. A foul again by the Storm. The lead is at 12. I will say we believe we should be speaking to Evan Jaffe at the end of this game to see what he has to say about his performance in the third quarter. That performance in the third quarter was huge because YHS was able to cut the lead from 10 to 5 at the end of the second, and it seemed like going into the third, they were going to be able to keep that momentum going. But whatever Coach Holland said to his team in the locker room during halftime seemed to work.
And I think exactly what they told him was to come out like they did in the beginning of the game, play high-tempo defense, high up the court, create turnovers. That's exactly what they did, and Evan Jaffe was able to convert off great looks off those turnovers forced.
He hits another two free throws there. And the lead is now 14. Three ball for YHS, no good. Fuchs gets the rebound as they foul again.
And
keep
Evan,
the clock stop.
And Evan Jaffe, I know I said he's had a lot of assists, also 11 points. And I'd like to point out the huge double-double by Ari Barshane so far. Four offensive rebounds contributing to his double-double with 10 points and 12 rebounds. That's a huge game for any center.
Again, that's two in a row. Double-doubles, rebounds. As Pat Riley says, rebounds win rings. And that's going to be important in this tournament.
I've never heard that. But thank you very much. I learn something new every day. I always thought it was defense. Or free throws, as you said earlier.
That's Mike Biamani, but he's not a basketball coach. He's just an announcer.
With 28 seconds to go, we'd like to remind everybody to keep it here for the post-game show coming up soon.
Something that you might not have noticed watching the stream, as the focus might not have been there, but Coach Verdugo did stress for his players to go up to players that they foul here as they try to keep the clock stopped. In a great demonstration of sportsmanship, something that we really appreciate here at Saracek.
As Jaffe will go back to the line, such a great free throw shooter, definitely putting the icing on this great game that he's had, leading towards Fuchs Mizrahi's win in this Tier 2 qualifier.
Evan Jaffe has definitely improved his free throw percentage this game as yesterday. Yesterday he only shot 25%, but today he seems to be shooting his free throws well. Three ball by Yitzi Kamineski goes.
And just to say hello, Rabbi Blauschier would like to get into the mix of saying hi to his team for Fuchs Mizrahi, as that is the final whistle. Fuchs Mizrahi winning 49-35 in this Tier 2 qualifier. We will send it out to the postgame show.
But stay tuned for our interviews with the winner team's star players and hopefully their coach as well.
In America's heartland, where our national pastime thrives, you'll find one of the most unique baseball tournaments in the world, the Columbus Baseball Invitational. This spring, join Jewish high school baseball teams from around the country as they converge upon the fields of Columbus to do battle on the diamond and forge lasting friendships off the field. The Columbus Baseball Invitational. 3 days of Jewish unity, spirit, and oh yeah, did we mention baseball? The Columbus Baseball Invitational, where age-old tradition collides headfirst into America's favorite pastime. The Columbus Baseball Invitational. To secure your place, contact Columbus Torah Academy or go to www.columbusinvitational.com. See your team there this spring.
And we're back for the postgame show with Ari Barshane and Evan Jaffe of the winning Mizrahi Mayhem. Great game, guys. Congratulations on winning this Tier 2 qualifier. Ari, you know you had a great game going, great matchup going in with Jacob Dennis. How did you prepare for this game?
There you go.
We've been preparing all season for this game. 14-2 record. We came in, we fought hard yesterday against Nuju. We lost, and we just got a good night's sleep last night. Came into the game prepared to win.
And Evan, the lead was only up. You guys were only up 5 going into the second half. You came out strong, had some great assists. I believe most of the points scored in the third quarter were off your assist. What was your mindset going into the second half?
I mean, I felt like we kind of slacked off a little bit at the end of the first half. We just need to take control. You know, this is our team. We have to regroup and come back strong. That's what we do.
And you know, to quote Jameis Winston, can't nothing be bigger than the game.
Very good, very good. And coach, I don't know if you can hear me, but the same, hold on, we'll get him a headset so he can hear what we're saying. Same question to you. Your team was up 5. They had a great first half. Weinbaum went on a little bit of a run. What did you tell your team at halftime to make them come out so strong in the third quarter to extend the lead?
Well, I mean, essentially we wasn't playing our brand of basketball, and we were making more mistakes, which kept them in the game. We had too many turnovers. We missed opportunities, so we had to just get back to Mayhem basketball.
Thank you very much.
Thank
guys.
You guys.
Congratulations on this Tier 2 qualifier win. Good luck at Tier 2. And thank you very much, guys. Good luck.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you very much for watching this broadcast of the Fuchs Mayhem versus the YHS Storm. Fuchs wins the game 49-35. I'm David Ellenbogen. This is Josh Cohen. And stay tuned for the next game between Yavne and TABC. Have
Thanks,
a good day.
Thanks, guys.